الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله وخير خلقه سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. So we will connect the meaning of today's ayat with the previous ayat last Sunday. As you know that the theme of this surah was about the question from the non-believers and their non-belief about the azab in the akhirah. They did not have the aqidah of akhirah, and they said that there is going to be no such thing like azab or punishment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered their questions, سَأَلَ سَائِلٌ بِعَذَابٍ وَاقِعٍ لِلْكَافِرِينَ وَلَيْسَ لَهُ دَافِعٍ. And the last Sunday, the ayat we recited, they were telling us that even those who were very close friends in this world, on that day no one will ask and no one will be helping for other friends. Even the close family friends, they will be running away from each other. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in today's ayat, Kalla, nay, this will never take place. As they are thinking that our tribe, our family, our friends will save us, it will never going to be happen. Kalla. Kalla means never. Innaha lava. Indeed, the punishment of the hellfire is in the shape of flames of fire. So lava means flame of fire. Innaha, indeed, this azab will be in the form of the flames of the fire, lava. Nazza'atan lishawa, and that will be so intense that will tear a part of their skin, of their body. So nazza'a, it is from nazza'a yanzi'u, to take away, to tear apart. Shava means skin, especially the skull and the skin of the entire body. So this shows the intensity of the flame of the fire, that the one who will be just in proximity, in the closeness of that fire, as soon as that person will be there, and alayazu billah, the skin of that person will be coming out of the body. Nazza'atan lishawa. Tad'u man adbara wa tawalla. That hellfire or jahannam will be calling. Tad'u, as you know, from da'a, yad'u means to call someone. So it will be calling all those people who turn their back from the commandments of Allah subhanahu. Tad'u, it will be calling man, everyone whom adbara turned his back, watawalla, and did not pay attention to the message of the truth and in belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wajama'a fa'awa. And all these non-believers, they accumulated their wealth. Jama'a means to gather, to accumulate. Fa'aw'a, and they preserved it, they saved it, and they did not spend this wealth or the part of the wealth in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to help the needy people, to deserving people. They did not use their wealth for the causes of humanity and for the causes of the khair. So jama'a means
accumulate.
To accumulate. Fa'aw'a, saved it. And calculated. This the word aw'a also has a meaning of calculating, always calculating the wealth. Oh, now I have so much, I have so much. Is increasing, 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 but not giving any penny, for the good causes. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلُوعًا. Indeed, human beings, they have been created restless. هَلُوعًا. هَلُوعًا means impatient and restless. Indeed, human beings, insan, khuliqa has been created halu'a, restless. Idha massahu sharru jazu'a. So now this is the explanation of that word halu'a, how they are impatient. Whenever any evil thing touches them, or any misfortune, any bad thing or calamity comes to them or touches to them, they started lamenting and crying, right? Jazua. So jazua means the one who started, you know, crying on that and showing very much impatience.
Is it also like complaining?
Complaining, yes.
Whining.
Yeah. So idha, when massahu, touch him, asharru, misfortune, jazua. So he started complaining, crying, lamenting on that. وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الْخَيْرُ. But when any good, any khair comes to him, now the good fortunes are coming to him, good things coming, manua. So he becomes very ungrateful and he stops helping other people and withhold his wealth in spending for the good causes. So manu'a is the person who is not giving anything out of his wealth that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon him.
What is the root?
Mana, like, no? We use it, huh? We say in Urdu also mana, I don't know, yes. Withholding, stopping, so becomes miser, bakhil. Okay, so these are all the bad qualities of the human beings, but who can control all these qualities and can change them into the positive manner? Illal musalleen. Those who are the ones who are performing their prayers constantly and on regular basis. Except, illa means except, al-musalleen, those people who are performing their prayer. So musalleen is the plural, jama, of musalli, and is from salah, as you know that. Alladheena hum ala salatihim. And who are the musalli? Those who are always regular on their prayers. Hum ala salatihim. They are on their prayer. Daimun. Daimun is from dawam. Constantly they are praying without missing their prayers or without any negligence of the prayer. It is not the case that someday they are praying, someday they stop praying. Or some prayers they are doing and some prayers they are not doing. No. It is the same expression as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in Surah Al-Ma'un, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. Destruction, woe to those people who perform their prayer but they are also forgetting and neglecting the prayers. So, what is the good quality of the salah? That they are doing it on the regular basis.
So, daimun is regular?
Daimun, regular, always.
Always.
Always. وَالَّذِينَ فِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ مَعْلُومٌ. And those people, they have the share in their wealth, and this share is very much known to them. So وَالَّذِينَ, and those people, fi أَمْوَالِهِمْ, in their wealth, حَقٌّ, they have the right, they have the share ma'loom that is known to them. So it could be the meaning of ma'loom could be the percentage of the zakat. Like they know that we have to give 2.5% zakat, that is known, known fact, ma'loom. Or the second meaning could be that in addition to the zakat, they keep giving the charity because they know that there is a share for the needy people, for the deserving people in their wealth. Hakkum ma'loom.
They know the right of
it. They know the right, or they know the right that is known to them. Lissa'ili wal mahroom. And they are giving to whom? The one who is asking. Deserving people, and they are all also asking for that. So deserving people are two types or two kinds. One, those who disclose their situation and they come forward and they are asking that we are in need of your help. So these are sa'il. Wal mahroom, and the other kind of people, they are deprived of the good fortune, they are in need, but because of their self-esteem and self-respect, they do not ask other people. They do not disclose themselves. So now this is responsibility of the giver that he should find out about those people and he should go ahead and help those people. He should not wait that when they will come and they will ask, then we will give it to them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he drew the attention of the people to those also who are deserving, but they are not asking. For both lissa'ili wal mahroom. So the literal meaning of mahroom, who is deprived
or in need,
or in need of the help, yes, but he is not asking. Watawalla means he did not pay attention and he did not accept the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who turned away.
Atbara is turned back.
And Watawalla turned away. Yes.